game. I'll probably just play WWE. All right. 3, 2, 1.
All right, guys. Welcome to our podcast, professionally done by yours truly, your mom, Haven Edge. Yeah. Anyway, everyone can introduce themselves. I already introduced me. I'm Jake.
Davin. I'm Chedzy.
My name's Carter. I have cancer.
Davin. All right.
I don't have cancer.
All right. So, death and drugs. I was not involved in this topic. It was these three, so...
Actually, Cheddar probably doesn't really know about it either.
Cheds, you don't know about it either?
I don't really know. I know death, though.
Alright, so this YouTuber guy.
Also our friend on Xbox.
Was our friend on Xbox.
Yeah, was. Basically, well, we don't really know for sure yet. Probably not going to be.
Yeah. So, basically, this guy, he's a faggot. Just kidding.
Well, no, he's not a faggot.
No. Anyways, he did some stuff and some things about 2 years ago, so he says.
Well, he did it last night, too.
He also did it last night. He smoked some weed and was drunk at the same time. Last time he did it was 2 years ago. And now he's pissed at basically everyone because of himself. It doesn't make sense.
He's a big fan of that Mary Jane that I'm hearing right now?
Dude, he is. Basically.
And that's why he got all mad at us yesterday.
Yeah.
He fell off the wagon and shook hands
with
the devil.
We're exposing him. Alright, yeah. Anyways, that's really all we wanted to talk about. We didn't really
care. Yeah.
By the way, his channel's Titan Gaming.
Yeah, Titan Gaming.
It'll take you an hour to find him, because that's how long it took for me to find him, because there's like about a million people with the same exact name.
Yeah, so his name's Titan Gaming.
Yeah, I gotta take him out of my
he's
featured
an asshole,
channels
kind
list.
Just, yeah.
Wait, he was in what?
My featured channels list.
Why'd you put him in there?
Well, that was before I found out.
He's in Carter's featured channels list, which is pretty
good. Yeah, that'll make it easier to put some hate on his ass.
Yeah, so. Anyways.
Wait, how many videos does he have?
Well, he's got more than me. He posts like 2 videos a day. What the fuck's wrong with this kid?
Mm-hmm.
That's impressive.
How many
it
subs?
Is impressive.
But he's still on
because he only goes to school for 3 hours a day.
How many subs?
He's got 3. Well, he's going to have 2 by tonight.
That's an astounding 3. That's an astounding 3.
Jesus. Alright. Let's talk about Black Ops 2, backwards compatible.
Alright.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Why do you guys think that it's not backwards compatible yet?
I think they just... I don't... Because they're fucking stupid.
I mean...
I feel like it's to keep people on the 360.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Probably.
I literally bought the game again just so I could have it on backwards compatible.
Yeah. I feel like the reason it's still backwards compatible is because people still go on their 360 to play it.
Yeah.
Like, if you think of Merc Music and stuff, he's going to go on there still.
It's keeping the 360, like, alive right now.
Well,
that's
dead. They're not even making them anymore.
Yeah, they're not.
Yeah. But it's keeping it alive for as long as it possibly can once it returns backwards compatible.
I feel like Treyarch's probably just fucking with him. Treyarch's been fucking with us for a while now, so...
Yeah, it took him like 5 months extra to get Black Ops on.
Yeah.
I mean, guys, they threw up that Call of Duty 2 without notice just like that, so...
Yeah.
That high-quality game.
That sweet game that everyone wants to play all the time.
Yeah, I almost have all the achievements in it.
Well, you're
not
cool.
Planning on getting them all, though.
How many are there, Shannon?
13.
13 achievements.
Wow, that is an entire...
That is insane.
Yeah.
You guys keep talking about this. Right. You have the ball game. What?
Chedzy.
What's your opinion
on this? Yeah, what's your opinion on this?
I think that the people that... Is it Activision who made that?
You're retarded, but yeah.
I don't know.
Activision took part in yes.
Okay, anyways. I think they're just lazy because...
They're just lazy, alright?
Yeah, and I don't know why, because they would make a lot more money.
I also feel, now that I think about it, I feel like they're keeping Black Ops 2 away from the Xbox One is because they're making so much money off supply drops, so.
Yeah,
that
Black Ops 2
is
such a good game.
That is true.
That is true, because
once
if
Black
they
Ops
did,
3 is done.
Yeah.
If they put Black Ops 2 on there, I'd stop playing Black Ops 3 entirely.
Exactly.
I'd
Everyone's
be straight
stop
on
playing.
Black Ops 2.
Yeah.
Yeah, that.
Trying to ground
and it's
where's
not,
my wall run?
Dude, I went on, the first time I was back on Black Ops 1, I tried to wall run. God. Yeah, I felt
tried to wall run.
I did, I'm not gonna lie.
I don't think that's ever been a problem for me. That's just cause like I go back and forth between Black Ops 3
Well yeah,
3
but when
and
you play like Black Ops 3 for like 6 months straight and then you go to Black Ops 1 for
Yeah, no, but I'm
the
like
first time in 3
I'm
years.
I'm swapping between I usually play MW3 and I hit up those 2v2 and 3v3 face-off playlists, and I just wreck shop on
Slippery
there.
Slippery snake.
Oh, look at that snake.
Slippery snake. Sneaky, sneaky snake.
They have no fucking clue what you're talking about.
He's got a snake on his shoulder.
Yeah, my snake is literally on his shoulder. He's a slippery, sneaky snake.
Alright, calm down.
Gotta Snapchat this.
Just kidding.
Snapchat it.
Yeah, that
way
you're
sneaky snake. Slippery.
Sneaky snake.
Swipe for filter. Put slippery, sneaky snake filter on. Alright.
Jake, one more thing, I think. I do think it's part of, like, your thing, but I also do think it's to keep it alive, because otherwise it's not going to...
It's probably helping more that it's on the 360 right now. We just want it on the freaking Xbox One. That's really all
right. Yeah. It should be coming out once Infinity Ward comes...
Put it on my
As
story.
Soon as Infinity Ward puts...
Infinite Warfare.
Yeah, they're probably going to release it, because then they can compete with Infinity Ward, because then they'll have Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 3. And I'd rather play Black Ops 2 and 3 compared to Infinite Warfare and Modern Warfare 4 Remastered, especially when I didn't even have nostalgia
COD
for the
four?
Game.
COD 4.
Whatever.
Modern Warfare 1.
Yeah.
Just Modern Warfare, I guess.
Yeah. Because I don't want to play a game that I've never really experienced remastered.
Yeah, Call of Duty's a big fan of trilogies, by the way. So.
Mm-hmm. Especially when I,
What if they made a trilogy of freaking World at War?
If they made
a
trilogy, that would be amazing.
Dude, I love World at War.
World at War was like almost everyone's favorite.
Greatest game ever in
history. I
have another
thing to add to the next topic, by the way.
Treyarch usually will always stay above like everyone when it comes to the Call of Duty games, because they just keep making good games.
Like, when it was Infinity Ward and Sledgehammer and they were making the Modern Warfare games, I thought those were great. Like,
those were great.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then Ghost came out and everybody wanted to kill him.
I enjoyed Ghost. Like,
same.
Yeah.
See, you either absolutely love Ghost or hate it.
No, I think it's alright.
It's a love it or you hate it. There's no, like, not really.
The one reason why Ghost is, like, so shit on is because, hear me out, all the guns are balanced.
No.
Almost every gun is balanced. Yeah, like
there's no OP gun.
Yeah, there's no like
I can agree with that.
There's no like overpowered gun. Like yeah, the Remington, but it shoots slow.
That's like the Man of War of Black Ops.
Yeah, it's the Man of War.
I hate that game because it didn't improve on anything.
That's true.
In my
opinion. Like
that's the reason I hate that.
It didn't have
game.
Anything like
it new. Made every but blowing up of certain areas of a 5-foot radius.
Yeah, that's why I play Battlefield frickin' 4 instead.
Oh jeez.
Yeah.
I'd rather play Battlefield than go and play Ghost.
Yeah, no, I was playing Bad Company, and
Bad Company 2. Oh,
yeah,
that was
Bad
greatest
stuff.
Game.
I was playing that, I think, last month, and I'm like, was this what Ghost is supposed to be? Because I blew up a complete building.
Logan, look, though. He's, like, in one... He's, like, going
with
through
one.
This way.
So...
Wait, did you download Battlefield 4?
Yeah, I have Battlefield 4.
Sick,
I'll
play that.
Logan, why wouldn't I have Battlefield 4?
I thought you had it as, like, a disc.
No, I got it downloaded. Alright, let's talk about Infinite Warfare now, since we were kind of getting into
it. Alright, we should... I have something to add to that, but, can we watch the trailer? Because I have not seen it.
Yeah, let's watch it live.
Look up the trailer.
Alright, look up the trailer. The only reason is because I have...
You want an actual
I've heard of something, but, like, yeah, I
want
to have an actual
opinion.
I hear it's supposed to be a boots-on-the-ground game. I hear that's what they're going for right now.
Well,
But
you're gonna be sadly disappointed. Oh god, I went down.
Oh, for a while, man.
Too good.
Wow, number one gameplay right here.
I thought he was going for the first room challenge.
Oh, I could have if I really wanted to, but I want box, so.
The one thing I was going to say was they have boots on the ground, but there are spider grenades.
Oh god.
So they're allowed to crawl on walls and they're like the HCXD.
I just don't even know what I think about that game.
I've not seen anything.
I'm hating it so far because it just sounds like Advanced Warfare. That's basically what it sounds like.
The last trailer I've seen was Suicide Squad trailer. Haven't even seen the movie yet. I wanted to, but no one
I heard that movie sucked.
Yeah, no, I know.
Yeah, I heard the guy who played Joker like put a lot of time into it, but they never even put him on.
The thing is, I feel like it sucks because they put all their jokes into the trailer because they did, and then they had to remake the like parts of the movie to make it funnier.
Okay, now do we all want to watch this or just let Davin watch it?
Let's just all watch it.
You guys can watch it. I've already seen
or,
it.
Yeah, I'm
just
right.
Keep the
I'm
volume.
Right, yeah.
Just keep the volume low.
Me and Chez will watch it quick.
We'll go to Edge just so.
Yeah, we'll be right back. You talk amongst yourself. Just make fun of Carter's shitty gameplay.
We'll keep talking about, like, Black Ops 2. So.
Do Black Ops 2, though. Origins. Best zombies map.
I just got windmilled in the air.
Yeah, I saw that. I can still hear it. You guys can turn it down, you know.
I'm closing up.
Yeah, anyways. You want to compare Origins to Revelations?
Oh, God. That's... I mean, like, there's certain parts of Revelations that are going to be good. Like,
yes.
This map. But the problem is like, they didn't have the entire map. All it has is stage.
Okay.
Right. Here, I'll take over for Jake. Alright. Chez, come on back in. Jake had to go do something quick. What'd you get? Mustang and Sally's?
No, this is just the
CZ-75.
Or CZ-75.
Alright. I'll go turn this down. Because
I can have a box.
I can just watch a trailer without sound, because, I mean, I'm able to play Call of Duty without sound, so.
Oh, dude, I got the Thunder Gun.
The Thunder Gun, hey?
The Thunder Gun?
The Thunder Gun.
Yeah, no.
Oh, yeah.
That's a nice seat right here. Alright, so I'm at the part of the trailer right now where they drop a just nuke on the map when everyone's storming the mountain.
Dude, I got a CZ-75.
What the hell?
Just the regular CZ-75?
Yeah, why would I want that thing other than the dual?
No, get two of them. Get three
dude,
of them, actually.
But I have the Thunder Gun as a second.
I don't care.
No. Not happening. So what's going to do?
You gotta talk to his.
Gotcha.
Ooh, they blew up a car. It's not like that's been done in every other Call of Duty.
Or any game ever.
Oh, sick of airplane. Oh, that's gonna be a fun time.
Airplane's confirmed.
Yeah, airplane's confirmed. I hope this is just a cutscene and zero interaction. Like, I don't plan on buying this game. I really don't.
Either do I. I don't even care if it comes with COD 4. It's not happening.
Like, I don't care about Battlefield 1 either. Like,
I don't know. Did you even play the beta for that? It's actually really good.
No.
What, Battlefield 1?
Yeah.
It was overhyped, like, from what I've heard. And that.
No, it wasn't, dude. It was actually so good.
No, like, I mean,
other than Black Ops 3, it was actually so much fun.
I haven't watched either trailer yet. Haven't watched any of the gameplay. Haven't played it. I still don't plan on playing it. Like,
how? Twice in a row, I got the CZ 70.
Get the CZ! They want you
got
to.
The dual
wheel. It's fate. It's fate.
It's not fate.
Alright, so it looks like half this game's taking place in space, and I don't like that.
Yeah, pretty much.
The thing I'm not understanding about this game right now.
When you see an old lady.
Dude, you're.
Shut up, no. Give me the tape measure. Alright, so.
Yo, it's my tape measure.
No, it's not, but what I was going to say was. Oh, go ahead, take my. Is. I don't understand why they even show the campaign anymore. Like, there's two types of people that play the campaign. Or
I mean, I've played the campaign of every Call of Duty,
like,
so far, and I don't plan to stop. But at this point, I probably won't because it just looks terrible.
I didn't play Black Ops 3's campaign just because, like, I didn't think it would appeal to me at all or anything. I played the first two missions. Second mission was long. Took me over, like... 30 minutes.
It had nothing to do with the two other Black Ops games. It was terrible.
Like, I'm fine with it not having anything to do, like, but considering you're calling it Black Ops, I'm pretty sure it's just because it's another Cold War. Like,
how did that not kill them?
I don't know.
The thing I'm not understanding about it is, like, why are you showing gameplay of the campaign when only basically YouTubers play it? Like, who, like, the Rad Brad and all that.
I don't because it's traditional to me, but...
Yeah.
That's...
Or... Kid...
That's gonna end.
Yeah, no. Or just people who go for achievements, which is me. I still didn't do that for Black Ops 3, because I did not care enough.
I finished Black Ops 3.
And really, I have no other people who would play it besides, like... Just, like, maybe some people who are... Like, when you're looking... You're just kind of looking for a quick shoot 'em up for like 3 to 8 hours. Sorry. 8 to 12 hours. That's what you're looking for. It's a Harley outside.
Yeah, they came here on the motorcycle.
Yeah. Slippery snake. Slippery snake's back.
Slippery snake.
So, Jay, what you're talking about was,
Slippery snake?
The campaign. Like, how they show campaign in the trailer when only, like, three types of people play it.
Yeah.
Play the campaign. Like, they either play it for achievements, for YouTube, or just, like, a quick shoot 'em up.
Mm-hmm.
That's all
also,
it is.
Also, did you see the jump boost?
No, I did not, actually.
Oh, there is a jump boost in it.
There is?
Yeah.
I just got enough for
what,
my door.
What kind of jump boost?
It's probably going to be a mix between
it,
Ghosts and Black Ops 3.
AW. Because Ghosts didn't have a jump boost.
Well, no, I mean, like, it's going to be kind of like Ghosts, but it's going to have, like, this stuff from Black Ops 3. That's what I mean.
Like, again, like I said again, I'm, like, have nothing against Ghosts. I actually am a fan of Ghosts.
I don't know how we got
too
there.
Lucky.
You should have died there, by the way.
You go and buy Jugga and Quick Revive.
No, you should just buy Jugga,
because,
I mean, like, then one of us gets the chance to play again, like, once he dies.
The score of the Browns game is.
Oh my god. Alright.
19-20.
Oh my god. Why?
Alright.
Who's winning?
The Browns?
The Browns? Alright, sick. Okay. So, Jake, do you have anything to add? Like, do you know what kind of jump system it is? Because they.
I believe
it's going to be just be a one boost.
Yeah,
jump.
I think it's just
not like
boost.
Black Ops 2 where you could jump once and then jump again.
Yeah, I think
like,
it's just going to be once and then you go up a little bit.
I will say, I was kind of skeptical about, like, the wall running in. Black Ops 3, but you don't need to use it. Like,
no, it's good. I like the way
it's pretty
it
simple. Like, you don't need to use it if you don't want to.
No,
like
I don't.
The couple of jumps though, like that one does, or like the one fluent.
I didn't care about using this anything.
Yeah,
boost up. That's the one thing I do have sort of a problem with, but other than that, it's fine.
Yeah. I think Modern Warfare or Infinite Warfare is gonna suck ass, and Battlefield 4 is basically gonna outsell it.
Battlefield 1.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I've been playing a lot of Battlefield 4. A lot lately.
Alright, you gotta go take care of something. Alright, we're gonna let you do that. So, what do you. Are you gonna buy Cheds?
I don't think so.
You didn't even buy Black Ops 3 until, like, months after. So.
Yeah, that's true. Carter, you gonna buy it?
I'm gonna buy it when it's like $5.
I might rent it. I'll rent it.
I'll probably rent it for like a week, see what it's about, and if it's terrible.
And if it's not AIDS, then maybe.
I'm probably gonna rent Infinite Warfare.
See, if my brother buys it, I'll play it.
Look at the rape trailer.
But it's like, that's gonna be like 4 months after, like, the hype's gone down about it, all the shit's gone down about it, and they have time to fix their shitty servers. I wouldn't shut the door.
What are you talking about? Bad servers. I don't have bad servers.
Well, when the games first come out,
shut the fuck up.
Games first come out, they have bad servers. That's just
Battlefield 1, I think, is going to be one of the greatest games of all time, honestly.
Of all time?
Yes.
Well, no.
Yeah.
Super Mario Bros. On the
I'm saying
NES
top,
is the best game ever.
I'm saying top 50.
But
I'm
like
top 50?
Yes.
I don't know. Avatar The Last Airbender, that's up there, along with the movie game. That one's another good
I'm
one.
I'm saying top 50. It's definitely going to be one of the greatest Battlefields, for sure. Might be better than Battlefield 2. Might be.
But will it be, like, this is an actual question I have. Will it be as much of a letdown as Dead Island was? I honestly thought
no.
Dead Island was a good game.
I thought Dead Island
was
good. I played the beta for that. It was a great game. Great.
No, like, Dead Island was
Dead Island.
Great.
It was great.
But, like, it looked nothing like the trailer. It had nothing to do with the trailer. And it was just kind of...
Are you talking about Riptide, or...?
No, just the original.
Just
the original?
Have you seen the original trailer with the girl falling out the window and everything?
Yeah,
no, that had nothing to do with it. People will hate it because of
that.
Yeah,
it was kind of a boring game.
Yeah, it was boring. It was more
like,
of a...
run, do
a task, come back, and then do another task.
I liked it.
Yeah, it wasn't bad, but it was like, it could... I haven't even finished it yet. Like, I have...
I finished it
and
no
got, like,
there.
Almost every achievement.
Almost every achievement? I gotta go back and play it then.
Pretty sure I got almost every achievement. I loved that game.
Yeah. Another game, like, I'd hope... The one game that I think can get away with it for me anyways, so I'm not sure if Skyrim is like this, because I really haven't played much of Skyrim or, like...
Neither have I.
Fallout or anything. I think it's more like Fallout, but, like, this is the one game I know that I absolutely can get away with. What I'm about to talk about is the, games that have, like, no really main story missions. They have, like, just a bunch of, like, side characters that you go get your side quests from, and, like, some of them have chances of being, like, main story things. Or, like,
Yeah.
No, like, the one game I think can get away with that is Borderlands, like.
I didn't really pay much.
Am I wrong? Like, no, I mean, like.
Yeah, I know.
Are you saying
about
that
have the multiple missions, like, get missions from different characters? Like, that's the one game I think that can get away with that.
I like Fallout 4 when they do that, because you can actually choose from different.
Well, yeah, but Fallout 4
like
also has the main thing, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
but there is also a lot of side.
Mm-hmm.
And you have four different, like, endings to choose from.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You either find your son, or you,
Alright, thanks. I haven't played it, but yeah, you know. Alright.
Hey,
well,
it's not like a spoiler for you.
No, I know.
Finding your
son's
gonna happen no matter what in that game. We're not gonna tell you how exactly.
I was just saying that. I'm not planning on playing it much. Like, if I play it, it's gonna be like out of boredom.
Do you care if we give away like the ending? Sort of the ending.
You should probably give a spoiler alert.
No, I'm talking to you and then we'll say spoiler.
I don't care.
Alright, so spoiler alert for
Fallout 4. Skip ahead, like, maybe 3 minutes or so.
Yeah, not even. It's probably gonna be less.
Less
basically, what happens is you find your son and he happens to be, like, 60 years old or something like that?
No, because you were out cold for, like, 200 years.
So what happened to the dog?
When you went to the cryogen.
How
chamber?
Old is he then? Just.
He's probably, like, 201 years old because he was a baby when he was taken. Right.
So basically, he was like, he's 200 years old.
Actually, no, he's not. He wouldn't be 200 because you had gotten woken up in the sleep and then you got to put him back. He'd probably be like 100 or something.
Yeah, alright. So basically,
he's old.
He's old as crap. That's what happens. And you find him. And he also is the leader of the Institute, which is terrible in every way.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Alright. I switched sides, by the way, because I wanted to leave. Shed too.
Yeah. Anyways, yeah.
Alright, so.
Alright, you guys, talk about Madden 17.
Madden 17? You just gotta give us 1 minute. Alright, perfect. I got that. Hey, buddy, how you doing? I'll take that one. Alright.
Just talk about Madden 17.
Alright, so, Madden 17. Cheds, what are your thoughts on it initially?
It's a good game and all, but I don't like how realistic it is.
Yeah, that's kind of my only thing too.
I like the way it looks and everything, just not how realistic.
It's like everyone says like it's going to be a reskin like every year, but I will say it's not.
This year is not a reskin.
It's like all new game mechanics are changed and it's really weird.
They brought back the weird kicking system.
Yeah, the weird kicking system, so it makes it like 10 times harder to kick field goals. Like on if you like actually play Madden, like if you say you play a franchise mode, like, if you're playing it on pro, you have no trouble whatsoever. But if you play on, like, all Madden, like I do, you're going to have some trouble kicking field goals. Because, like, it'll go, like, that's the hardest difficulty in Madden to play on. And it'll go from, all right, we're going to move this for you, and, like, you're just going to tell us when it stops. Well, like, you have to predict when it's going to stop on all Madden. Because, like, you have no way of telling if you're going to come close to making it or not, and... There's also, you can Blair Walsh it hard if you wanted to. It's a lot easier to Blair Walsh in this game than it is in any other game.
Yeah, I'm not buying this Madden 17, I'm not.
Yeah.
I bought Madden 16, I'm good for another year.
Jake, you're a more casual fan of Madden, so I don't expect you to want to buy it. Whoa, we almost knocked over a lamp there. But Jake's a more casual fan of Madden, so I don't think he'll want it. The catching in the game, it's a lot harder because it doesn't matter. Like, you can have a perfectly placed pass, like, perfectly placed bullet pass from, I'm a Steelers fan, so I'm going to use this analogy. It can go from Ben Roethlisberger straight to Antonio Brown, one of the best wide receivers in the NFL, my opinion, like, right now, in my opinion. There are some good ones, but I mean, I think he's really good. And he's used right, but... You can have a wide open like bullet pass, and he can drop it. It makes no sense. Like if it's wide open, an NFL receiver will most likely catch it. And the like rack catch, run after catch. Like I get running and catching is hard, But, like, you catch it, then run. Like, that's what the NFL's people do. They don't catch it, like, and then, like, run while they're catching it.
Yeah.
Like, they don't keep moving when they're catching it. Like, they don't focus on still running when they're about to catch it. They focus up on the catch instead. But there are those drag routes also don't work anymore. And if they, like, I think that's great, though. Like,
yeah,
the drag route system, because when you play online, people would immediately just tear through your
line.
They
just, like, use the mesh play or whatever.
Yeah, they just use, like, mesh or Y shallow. They like to use that a lot. And like they, if they have Landry, no, what is his name?
Something
Green. Plays for the Steelers. He's got like 89 speed to 90 speed as a tight end.
Ladarius
Green. If you throw it to him, I had a mind fart there. But you throw it to him on a drag route, like
that's linebackers, a solid, like 4 to 5 yards.
Yeah, most linebackers, you'll get 4 or more yards off of it because he's faster than almost all the linebackers in the game. Like, Anthony, all the middle linebackers. Like, the only person who might be able to catch up to him is Shazier, maybe Keekly. Who else? Chedz, who's also pretty fast. They could catch you. Maybe not. No, Navarro Bowman's not that fast.
Let's try and speed this up because I want to get to some other stuff.
Yeah, no, we're just trying to stretch it out until like one of us gets to play another game because it's going now.
Alright, are you can end your game or whatever.
You can do whatever you want.
I just want to show people. So.
Alright.
After I do this, then I'll end it.
Alright. So,
let's talk about your 7-day survivor achievement.
Alright, I have apparently a minute to do this.
You have a minute to do it. I'm timing it right now. You have a go.
Okay, so my 7-day survivor achievement, if anyone wants to know, it's a Dead Rising achievement where you have to spend, I'm pretty sure, 14 hours without pausing the game, without taking a break. Like, you have to go and finish the whole game nonstop. It takes 14 hours, and I'm going to have to do that on Saturday. I will come back maybe next week, and I will tell you if I got it or not.
Oh, crap.
So, 30 seconds.
30 seconds? All right. So, I have to... What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to look up a way to do it. I kind of already did that this week, this Saturday. So, I got a week to prepare, and I'm going to try hitting a higher level on Friday so I have at least enough health to where I can run, get everything I need, get a bunch of food rations,
10 seconds.
Orange juice. And then go kill all the survivors, run back, meet the guy on the rooftop at the 7 days, and I'm done. Bang.
All right, you had 1 second to spare. Good job.
I'm glad I was limited to 1 minute on
okay,
that.
I just want
to
say this.
I could have rambled for 5.
All right, let's talk about Revelations.
Oh, I'm going to end this, so wait real quick. I just want to say that I packed, so I got the Afterburner, and I got the Zeus Cannon.
Coming down.
I think I only got one. No,
yeah,
I didn't
one.
Get any.
No,
yeah, I got
one
because I lost.
You're bullshitting
you
with
suck.
Us. Alright, so. I would like to also preface this. Who's playing next, by the way?
Either you or you. Alright. I'll play one.
Alright. Logan, which one you want, me or you?
Okay.
Alright. We'll probably just come up with new topics because we're decent at rambling for everyone to play.
Alright, here.
So I'll be playing. I'll be playing WWE. I know it's not a popular game, but
I'm just
going to
go
until
I run out of ammo on this.
It's something I'm decent at, so I'm going to play that, because Jake...
Then you can just quit the game.
Jake
yeah,
doesn't want me to play anything else, so...
Cool. Anyways, alright, let's talk about, Revelations.
Revelations. Alright, I have not heard about this, to preference this.
Alright, I want you to go on there and you can look up Revelations right now.
No, I'm good. I'll just listen.
Alright, Revelations. What happened was,
thanks, man.
Basically, in Revelations, it sucked ass. It was the worst ending I've ever seen to anything.
Well,
ever.
The reason it was the worst ending.
Music. We never fixed that.
Okay, so the.
We'll fix that.
The reason it was the worst ending is because it was the actual ending.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. And they did a terrible job at actually ending it.
Did a terrible job.
So
the thing
like
with the staffs, it's so stupid.
Basically
then,
what happened was at the end, they showed the staffs. You couldn't use the staffs, and didn't end the entire game, like you couldn't go back and play
yeah,
it.
Yeah, they ended it.
Yeah, you ended the game if you did the... If you
did
it,
the Easter egg,
you
ended the game. You're done.
Completely ended the game.
And the cutscene showed the stuff.
What's the... How can I turn off the sound?
Anyways, fine. Yep, it sucked. It was the worst ending you could possibly get for it. You would think that maybe Richtofen would die or something, save everyone. Or just something. Something should have happened.
Chat mixer.
It was.
Why don't you just go press start when you get into the game?
Dumbest thing.
You can have 25 seconds of copyrighted music.
Carter, what do you think?
It's just they did a terrible job. Like, it was all hyped up because, you know, it's the last Zombies map, which probably won't be.
Jake, get ready.
But
yeah, it's not the last.
When I start playing this game, just start muting. Just, like, mute this. What?
I can't.
You can't mute the...
So just... Where
you
at?
When you get into a game, just press start.
There you go. Alright, you're good. Alright, so anyways, it was...
It's like...
I don't know.
You're ending this huge story for something that's been on for how many years? Like, what was it when,
So it was back in World at War in, what, 2008?
Yeah. You have this huge story, it's like 8 years old now, and you end it like that and everybody is gonna be mad.
And
you couldn't have figured out something to make it good.
You could have killed a character and would have made it way better.
Yeah.
Literally.
I mean, they already killed a character. Like, they've already tried that. They used to have a Mexican, and I'm pretty sure they picked up, I think, Dempsey or somebody like that. I don't remember who it was, but they picked up someone like that. Now we're going to go to normal.
No clue what you're
talking about. No, it was in World at War that they did this.
Whatever.
Good talk, guys. Good talk.
Anyways.
I'll go ahead and shut up now.
It was just a terrible ending. Basically, that's what we want to talk about. Or Revelations, terrible ending. Let's talk about Revelations compared to Origins.
Revelations compared to Origins, dude. Holy
Orange's best map of all time, hands down. Revelations, I don't even think it could be second.
Revelations, it could have been made better easily.
Easily.
If they had, okay.
They had the staffs.
If they had the staffs. Two, if they had brought in more of the maps back.
Yes.
And made them the entire map.
Yeah.
Like, on Kino, all they have is the stage.
Yeah.
Right? And then on, like...
They should have made the maps bigger, and they should have added maybe a...
And it's not like it's impossible.
So what did they do on Revelations, by the way?
They put a whole bunch of maps, combined all of them, and
so
they're just
the World
parts
that
of
War,
it.
Like, Bunker, and then they had...
Alright, so I'm assuming that's an actor on Toten that you're referring to?
Yeah.
Alright.
And then,
They had a bunch of maps.
Yeah,
so
they had
Origins,
a bunch of maps,
they
only had parts of them.
Yeah, they had Shield.
And the reason they could only have parts of them is because they added all this other bullcrap.
Yeah.
With the pack punch going into that big, huge, fat slug in the sky.
Yeah.
And like, you didn't need that. Asshole. What we wanted was an original map.
Yeah.
Well, like, parts of the original maps.
Yeah.
All put into one thing, and that would have been great. Mm-hmm. All you had to do was that.
You know, there's
you
no...
You could have figured out any way to put the story into it.
Yeah. Dumb. Terrible.
So, is this, like, all the zombie storyline that they have now?
Yeah.
It's
over.
It's over completely.
100%. Well...
It's not
well,
over,
actually,
but...
They can't make a World at War 2, because they can't make a Zombies.
They can easily make
a World at War 2, they just use different
Unless
characters.
They made a Zombies that was, like, Black Ops 2, Town, where it wasn't even the characters.
No, all you gotta do is...
They could probably do it, they could just add some random stories in.
Like, no, like,
them.
Transit, that didn't have a story, didn't have the characters in
it. No, but it could
have...
Yeah,
it did. Oh,
did it?
No. Yeah, it did.
I thought it was,
the
people in the suits and the hazmat suits.
Jake Achievement.
Okay.
Gamer score. Nope.
Oh, that's great.
Anyways.
Yeah.
But they could make World at War 2 and just add, like, from
start
World...
Start a new story.
Or they could just...
Redeem yourself.
Yeah, they could
they
start another story
themselves.
Again. Again, they could do it again. Yeah.
I honestly
Origins,
don't.
Definitely best map.
Yeah.
I have
the
to
only
say...
thing I don't like about Origins is how they can deny you the pack of
Yeah.
Like, they can shut all of them down.
That's true, yeah.
That's the one thing I don't like. If they didn't have that, I'd love it even more. It would
Logan,
be...
what do you think?
I would like to say...
Thumbs up, they can't
I think
hear Rebel, thumbs
I
up.
Think Der Eisendracha is easier to compare to Origins. I think that map is probably going to be better.
Yeah,
Der
Eisendracha is a pretty good map.
Yeah,
just because it's like it's got the older aspect to it.
Yeah.
You can easily compare it to Origins because, like, the bows, even... That's
yeah.
The only thing I don't like about Dragon, They didn't add any of the weapons in because Prayer is just a bunch of assholes.
They had the weapons in the Go Rod, but they didn't add it to
Nope.
Darius and Jackass.
Yeah. That's the only reason I like to play Gorod more is because they have the new weapons, and I can't get them on multiplayer because
shitty backlog.
Yeah, exactly. And you can't get the pipe on Dur. So, yeah. The PPSH, yeah. Dryzen Draka,
I'm about to drop this boy.
I think
great Dryzen Draka. Just...
Well, out of what is on Black Ops 3 at the moment, it's probably a 5. Right next to Gorod. 5. Both of them.
5 out of 10?
Oh, by the way. You mean out of 10?
Yeah,
well,
out of
10. Oh, never mind. Like, I would rate Dryzen Draka 9 out of 10. And then everything else
Calf
is garbage
crusher.
On that game.
Gorod is pretty decent.
Yeah,
I'm going to rate Gorod like... 7.
Because
probably.
It's like, it's got these dragons and stuff
it's
in it. It's
pretty
like,
good.
It's pointless.
And no, the thing is, though, about Gorod, they actually tried to make something new, and I like that, so.
Yeah,
and it worked out decently, so. Let's what's the old map that they added before that?
Ricelands?
Girl.
It's Unoshima.
Shima.
I'm gonna rate that about 3. 3 out of 10.
I haven't even played it, and I know it's garbage.
3 out of 10.
Like, I thought it was supposed to be like a remake of Shinonuma. Turns out it's not.
No, it turned out to be worse than Shinonuma, honestly.
Shinonuma's great. Shut your fucking mouth.
It has parts to do with Shinonuma, but it's like...
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah.
It doesn't really.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they're trying to, but it doesn't.
Yeah. The
like
giant...
You tried.
The giant is...
Frog splash.
What do you think?
Ready?
What do you think? I think,
ready?
Like, 8.
They could have done a better remake, for sure.
Yeah, they could have. They could have added probably
jump!
More, too.
Yeah.
I don't know why I have to be on top rope.
But, like...
Oh, come on, hit him with the frog splash.
The thing that sucks is there's no Easter egg in it. There's, you can
frog.
Get...
No, that's not. That's 450, my bad.
Whatever.
Is there, like... Does it... Okay, does the giant remake have its own, like, story? Or does it have the same story?
It starts
right,
the story.
That's right.
It starts the story.
Ready?
Boom! But
like,
does it have the
Black
same
Ops
story as the remake, though?
No.
That's so stupid.
Because they went back in time to change the remake, to change the old one.
Oh, okay.
Because they killed the whatever.
Yeah, gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes more sense.
Yeah.
Wait, so let's hear everyone's top zombie map, like everyone's favorite zombie map.
Origins, easily.
Origins, alright.
I have to go with Keen Order Totem for sure.
I think
fair.
I gotta say...
it's just because it's like the first zombies map I played, and it's, I don't know.
I like
just
because
everything on there is the like most original.
Shadows.
Yeah.
I
just so stupid looking.
Are you serious?
Shadows of
no.
Evil.
Alright.
I will say the one map like that could have been better if it got rid of like a couple things. One, you got Pack Punch more accessible, which is like it's transit.
Transit.
It was transit. Like,
transit could have been good.
You made transit like you made Pack Punch more accessible. That would have been great.
That's the one thing.
And you like didn't.
Thing.
Always, and you didn't have Denison, and you didn't have like those huge pits of lava where you can't run around the whole map. Like
you can't because if you run from one spot of the map to the other, you got that big guy all in your face, cutting your eyeballs out, just killing you. Can't really get there.
Yeah, if they would have got rid of the like they should have made it so that zombies were harder if you ran outside of the parts of the map.
Exactly.
Yeah,
but they shouldn't
like,
have added lava. Who the hell thought of that? Fucking retard.
Like, no, the lava wasn't as bad. Like, in the town.
It was.
In
yes,
the town,
was.
I get. Like,
yeah,
town
was
lava.
Bad. Everywhere else, it was fine. It was kind of annoying. Just
like you couldn't have had. You shouldn't have had that much lava. Like, the pack
the
punch.
The lava was stupid. Who the fuck came up with that?
I will say, I did like the bank idea. Like, the grenade door at the bank. I liked that. That was
yeah,
a nice
that
touch,
was cool.
But
I guess
with
stuff,
the
cool.
Pack Punch after that, I hated that.
I feel
that.
Like the Pack Punch, you should have just turned on the power and should have just said, fuck it. There you go. There's the Pack Punch.
Yeah.
Or you should have paid to open the door to Pack Punch, which is another $5,000 or some shit.
Pick up the ladder. That's fucking great game.
And you had to build the Pack Punch. What the fuck?
Yeah, you did have to build the Pack Punch. I mean, it wasn't that, like...
It's not like it was hard. It was just stupid.
Yeah, it was just more
negative. The problem with that is, like, you had to get all the way around the map just to do it.
And if you got down, you're screwed.
Exactly.
Trying
because
to pick
you
up
can't
the
get any...
You can't pick up the ladder.
Like, you
no.
can't get quick revive. You can't get anything
mm-hmm.
until you get... And then you gotta go, what? Through Eagle K.
Like...
You start at the bus station.
We want
you
big
go
match.
To, What's the next
one? We want Big Mac?
No, you're stupid. Alright.
Like Mac from Always Sunny in Philadelphia? Yes, no?
So
no.
You spawn right. In, you're at the bus station, and you go to somewhere else. I think it's another bus. No, it's a gas station.
You get to gas
and
station.
And a diner. Then you get to town. No.
Logan, you can just go up
there. Yeah, you get to town, and then you get to farm. You get to farm.
Who the fuck wants
to farm? Farm was terrible. Farm was everybody always skipped past that. Everybody just stayed in the bus and waited to leave.
Am I the only one who never actually, like, ever skipped past farm just because, like, I liked the, like...
Yeah, you're the only one who never skipped past farm.
I only went to farm when Box was there.
Yeah.
That's the only
time
I went
to farm for three reasons.
You're gay.
Double tap. Double tap.
You're gay.
Wait, no, actually, I don't think that was even there. That wasn't even there.
Yeah, it was.
Was it?
No.
Yes, double tap.
Oh, I'm thinking. Yeah, it was there.
Double tap was there. One more. Two more things. They had the fridge. So.
The bears.
The fridge, because you could get any weapons you wanted on there.
The fridge is a good idea.
And then.
I like the bank.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The bank's a good addition.
They should have kept that in.
Always bad and stuff, but.
Yeah.
I will say, probably one of my favorite maps, I'm gonna get a lot of shit for this, but Die Rise. I really liked it. Like, I'm the only one who actually really liked Die Rise.
I didn't think Die Rise was that bad. I didn't like it, though, either.
Yeah, but like, what I was saying, like...
It was the biggest troll, though, for PhD Plop.
Oh, I hated PhD. I never...
You're fed. PhD. They trolled you because they gave you the room for it, and you couldn't get to it.
Is there even one map in the entire thing that gives you that? Which one?
My favorite map.
That one, the easiest map of all time.
Oh, roll them up, roll them up.
The one where it has that big giant dude on it. That can destroy ours.
Who's up?
Logan.
I just kicked the shit out of Simon Dodge. Ah,
crap.
There's one map that you can actually get it on, but you have to get it some secret stupid way. I don't remember how.
So there's only one map that actually has that? That's so stupid.
The Black Ops 1, amazing, because it was just so simplified.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, anyone who was just watching my shitty gameplay,
well, that's pretty good.
When I wasn't doing anything, I was trying to pick up that ladder and...
Do you like 5?
Yeah.
Wow.
Dude,
I rate 5 out of 10.
Well, actually,
I absolutely fucking hated 5.
There was some good parts about 5.
5 was fun just because...
It was just hard, though.
Yeah.
Hard as shit.
Yeah,
if it was easier, would have been a great match.
If you didn't have to do what you had to do to get freaking Pack-a-Punch, it would have been fine.
I mean,
but,
no, if it would have been a little bigger and more open space, and it didn't have that one douchebag in it.
That's traced you around a lot.
Oh, I hated him.
And if it would have had less of the Nova 5 motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That killed you every time.
I hated going down to that one area, like, where you turn on the power.
Yeah.
You could get cornered so easily. Like,
yeah, because it... And then you got all these teleporting areas around there. That was annoying.
You know what? Wait.
I've seen someone drop over 100 rounds on that, and I, like, immediately gave them the most credit in the world. I actually donated $5 to the stream just because that was impressive to me.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, I get it. I'm a cheap fucker. I only donated 5. I don't give a shit.
Hey, it could have been cheaper and not donated him anything.
That's true. I could have.
All right. Let's talk about Killer Keemstar. Let's get right into the news.
Okay,
I'm gonna kill my son now.
He's a fucking idiot. Right?
Keemstar is the biggest retard in the world. Goodbye. That's the podcast.
At this point, it's like, he's just a meme.
He's a killer meme star. Right?
Shut up. You deserve to die after that.
Don't worry.
Cheds, go ahead and play one game and then we'll hand the roll over to Jake.
And then after this, it'll be in an hour and then we'll call her good.
Yeah.
And then we'll go and get some food, maybe make another podcast.
Jake, what about yours? I'd be down for another podcast.
We'll probably make another podcast. Obviously, maybe it'll be like 30 minutes. A little less than this, probably, because this is like an hour. Keemstar, he's a fuckboy and an idiot. Alright, good.
He is.
Well, okay, it's like...
Don't even know who he is.
He's a manipulating hypocrite, alright?
Yeah.
It's like... He says all these things about people, like, oh, what's wrong with you? You called this guy a pancake. And then he's like, a few months later, he's like, oh, if you don't like freaking Sniper Wolf, you're a faggot. Like, did you not just say a few months ago that if you call people that, like, you, like, he said, like, that's a word that's used to kill people.
Well,
like,
football?
No, that's so stupid.
No, skipped over that one.
Keemstar,
skip the stool.
He's just.
He brings out, he called that one old guy a pedophile.
Yeah, that was the
stream.
Worst thing
calls
ever.
Calls Basher versus a pedophile, almost makes him kill himself.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Like.
I get it, you're a news reporter, but what the hell?
And he's still on YouTube.
Yeah, and YouTube's
he's already
not,
banned.
He's
right?
Got a good way to keep his job, guys.
He's got a loophole. Right?
And that shouldn't be a loophole.
Because somebody else owns the channel. Like, so what? He should be banned off YouTube. Shouldn't even be allowed in people's videos.
No, he shouldn't.
Unless they're making rants or jokes about it.
I like the part where you said. Wow. Alright, in the other controller. No.
I wish that's what we did.
Joins mid-game. Oh, God.
Give
funny.
Me the controller.
Oh, damn, my eye hurts.
Yeah. Let's talk. Let's keep talking about Keem. He.
He leveled up like 1 XP.
Wait, Jake, can I tell my story quick about my eye?
No, you can tell it later. Alright,
I can tell it later. Alright.
You get it's 20 seconds to tell about it.
It's still bothering me.
Alright. So, Keemstar, did you hear about what he was in before? Like, how he started off?
He was in Call of Duty trolling.
Yeah.
What?
And he was in one of the, like, top 5 trolling channels, and he was just an asshole to everyone. Just the biggest shit talker ever.
Oh, but there's no one.
He got banned off of YouTube for that, didn't he?
Yeah.
Why is there no one level 10,
yeah.
like, or above in this lobby?
I don't know.
What are you doing?
Are you stupid?
Oh, I was looking at the...
You're stupid. Davin's stupid. Confirmed. Anyways.
I can't see that small.
Floosy tube. Floosy tube.
Floosy tube sock.
Don't know who the fuck
that
is.
Yeah, you can mainly talk about
him
because I only know a little bit about him.
Okay, I'm just going to make fun of Logan's
gameplay. I don't really know too much about him. He's just so annoying. Like, he says stuff like, what's your ad? Like, okay. So his best friend's Roman Atwood.
Yeah.
His entire thing's like, oh, you got to smile more, do all this. That's his best friend. Yet... He talks all this crap to Leafy is here. He's like, what's your address? I'll be at your house to see what you say to my face. Like, what is wrong with you?
Lucy too said that?
He says all this stuff about trying to be happy all the time. Then he says something like that on Twitter. And it's like, if you,
Twitter's the ultimate place to talk shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like, when you're one of these people that tries to get people to think good all the time, then you do stuff like that. It's just so stupid. Like...
There's a lot of hypocrites on YouTube. Those two are the biggest hypocrites, honestly.
Yeah.
And then there's PewDiePie, but he jokes around about it, and he knows he's a hypocrite, at least.
Well, yeah.
You know, you're the biggest YouTuber, you know.
I am one of the only people who did not give a shit about PewDiePie. Like, I never cared.
Still, like,
I never cared until he started making, like, it was like a few months ago where he started to make actually pretty good videos.
Yeah, he started to care a lot more rather than just wanting. Because,
like, at the beginning, when he's, it was like, once he got up until, like, when he was at 40 million, right?
Yeah.
That's when YouTube started to make YouTube red.
Yeah.
So he was doing all that stuff, didn't really have much time to make videos.
Yeah, he didn't have time to make videos.
So that's when his quality went really far down.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
His quality went down, but it's not
and
really
then
his
he's
fault.
Back now, and his videos are great. They're probably better than they ever were. So,
well, I liked him back when he was at, like, 20 million. I loved his videos.
Is he still scared of, like, chairs? No, barrels? Is he still scared of barrels?
No, he jokes around about barrels. Himself now.
It's harder for him to get scared now, though. That's what sucks.
The only thing I've ever, like, actually watched fully... of his was his Bully series. Because I really enjoy Bully, like, the game.
We're doing a lot of dust. Let's talk about Ian, and we'll talk about football, and we'll end it.
Alright.
Ian.
So, you guys know who Ian is? That one guy that posts farts on his channel.
Ian Mahler, just my guy.
I used him in one of my videos one time. It was terrible.
Much
Ian, quit
right
farting, you faggot. That's basically all I have to say.
Let's talk about the time Ian farted so hard, he had to throw his underwear away in the bathroom.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious.
Like in 8th or 7th or something?
Eighth
I thought this was supposed
year.
To be like a 1-minute topic.
Yeah, this is going to be a 1-minute topic. Alright, yeah, basically, Ian, quit shitting yourself. That's all we really wanted to say.
Yeah,
you need
stop
help.
Stop having to throw away your underwear in the middle of school.
Yeah, you need help, and we're here to help you to get through this. We're not going to
hold
opening. Your parts for you, though. Quit cupping the cheese. Anyways.
Take
Jake, I think we gotta, like, talk about football a little bit, because...
That's what we're doing, retard.
No, I'm anyways. Saying, like, a little bit Jesus. More. A little bit more is what I'm saying.
Like to apologize.
Than yep. what we're probably limited to, because Cheds...
We're talking about football. Right?
Yeah, no, Cheds needs, like, 80 kills to win.
All right, let's talk about football.
All right.
This is our last topic, and maybe we'll talk about some news. All
right, so... Let's hear everyone's favorite teams first. I've already discussed
main
this.
Main quarter Bears. Second, yeah. My second favorite, though, is the Panthers.
Well, no, Jake's before, a bandwagoner. Jake's okay. a bandwagoner. Like that's something you should know.
Before we say that we're Bears fans, we need to say, like, why. We didn't just
my
become
father,
Bears.
My
we've
pops.
Been Bears fans, like, for our entire lives, not just recently.
Yeah.
Because they're terrible now. And
yeah.
We're going to...
Watch as they're going to get good someday, and then those guys... Oh, you're bandwagoner. I'm just going to... Fuck you.
Like,
anyway.
And, like, the thing is, like, we've lost all these people. Now they're just garbage.
We
they
lost
fired
Devin.
Our kicker.
Mm-hmm. We Robbie lost Devin. We lost Robbie.
Yeah, Robbie Gold.
Don't we have, like,
Devin
Alshon,
Hester.
And that's about it?
You guys, Jeffrey. Yeah, Alshon, Jeffrey.
We got...
And we keep Cutler.
Yeah, we keep...
Why do we keep Cutler?
We keep the worst person on our team. Literally the worst.
And the
Kyle
reason,
Long's
the reason
a
we had
stud,
to kick
though.
The,
Kyle Long is also amazing.
He's a
reason,
stud.
The reason we had to kick, or the reason we had to fire the kicker was because...
I see what you did there.
The
kick,
the
kicker.
Shut the hell up.
Shut
the
hell up.
The reason we had to fire the kicker was because we were paying Cutler too much.
Yeah.
Paying Gee Cutler too much.
Well.
And that's a fact.
I'm predicting the Bears are going to go like 4 and lose every game.
All right, so,
yeah, I haven't even been watching because I'm just guessing that we're all always going to lose.
We're going to lose. We're obviously going to win some game. Probably against the Packers.
Dude, we totally could beat the Super Bowl this year.
Okay, so.
This year, man.
My favorite team.
Well, next year. You know what
I've already discussed.
This
but
season, bitch.
I'm a Steelers fan. No real reason behind it. Like, I've kind of needed a team. Like, I was growing up in a Packer family.
Just so you can know.
I was growing up in a Packer family. Sorry, I can hardly hear, so.
Yeah. All right, you continue.
I was growing up in a Packer family, and I didn't want that shit, so I decided to pick a team of my own.
Fair enough.
That's basically why I'm a Bears fan. You
Steelers,
don't
so.
My entire
and I don't want to get shit from anyone. I know our defense sucks, and we have a juggernaut offense. I don't want to fucking hear it. I know our defense sucks, all right?
Could you imagine their offense and the...
Their Broncos offense and
defense.
Our
defense. Yeah, and the Broncos' defense.
No, here. Jake, their offense and our defense from 3 years ago.
From 3 years ago. Our defense was...
Didn't they have Urlacher?
Yeah, they had Urlacher back then.
That's what I thought.
And, Julius
way
Peppers.
Back in the day.
They
oh,
still,
I
we
love
still
Julius.
Got Peppers, don't we?
No.
No,
we lost
don't.
Peppers, too?
We lost Peppers like 2 years ago.
Peppers went back to the Packers?
Peppers? Oh,
yeah.
No, we lost Peppers last year. Now I remember.
Yeah.
Cause
he was
they,
on the Panthers originally, right?
Because Julius...
I thought it was
okay,
on the
okay, so Peppers right and Urlacher next to each other. They were so good. That's
yeah.
what made our defense so much better than everybody
yeah, because
else's.
We had the two best. Because
them two, they were always on, like, they were always on somebody.
They were the best.
Yeah.
They were
and
the
now
best.
Our defense mm-hmm. is terrible. And the reason our defense is terrible is not only because all of our good defensive
we need
players left, is because we have an offensive coach now.
Can we just make an all-rookie... fucking lineup and just
wait,
because
wait,
we
wait.
Lost Lovie Smith.
Wait, we gotta hear Ched's favorite team.
I like the Lions.
Faggot.
I'm the only one who's not in their division.
Well,
I'm
not...
in the AFC even, so I'm the odd man out.
Well,
in
you
the
know,
AFC.
The good thing
yeah.
about Logan is that you know he's not a bandwagon. No
yes,
band
I am
wagon.
A bandwagon.
Jake.
Yeah, so, I liked them. For since
the
three years ago.
You like the Panthers from. Let's find out.
Last year.
Yep.
Last year, first game of the season.
Oh my god.
So, Jake, who's your favorite basketball team?
Fuck basketball.
Dude,
is it,
actually,
is it,
anybody watching this
Chicago,
video,
Chicago.
If you want to buy a
Chicago Bulls.
A Michael Jordan card from the 95, I'm selling it on eBay.
Shut the fuck up.
Wow, way to plug your own shit.
Dude,
yeah,
I have
this
like,
video
is
sponsored by Frigid Gaming.
Yeah, just sub to me.
Yep, sponsored by Frigid Gaming.
Another shameless
say,
plug.
Go follow my Instagram.
Hey, it's Ryan.
Go follow
this
my Instagram.
This video is also sponsored by, yeah.
Hey, Cortana, open chat.
Shut up.
Alright.
This video is sponsored by Cortana.
This video is sponsored by my Instagram. Go follow it.
This video is sponsored by myself.
That was making me mad.
All right, so what's the next topic? Or is it half?
Erlacher's great, and he's playing.
So
again.
Is Julius Peppers.
Right. But you know what?
The thing is like Erlacher was like 42 when he left.
Yeah.
So he needed to leave, otherwise
so
he's
still
die.
Younger than Peyton.
All right. Wait. Can we talk about how the Rams have... Cheds, how long has it taken the Los
Let's
Angeles
get
Rams to get a win? Like, how many years has it been since the Los Angeles Rams have got a win?
I don't know, but a few weeks, or...
What do you mean a win? Like, no.
A win. How long has,
it's,
like...
They haven't scored a point since 1994.
Sorry, that's what I meant to say. Scored a point since 1994.
Are you for real?
I'm not even joking.
That's true fact.
This is 100% true fact.
Shit.
If you didn't know, they were originally called the St. Louis Rams.
No, they weren't.
Terrible.
Sorry, they weren't originally called that. They switched to that, and now they're back to the Los Angeles Rams.
Yeah,
they seriously haven't scored a point for that many years?
Uh-huh. And then it used to be the
really
LA Raiders.
You didn't hear what I just said? They switched names, Jake.
Yeah.
They switched cities.
And then they switched back.
So, I'm gonna pick a new favorite football team. I'm gonna pick the Oilers.
Hey,
that's
same.
The team still.
I like the Bears, so I also get the
Who'd the Oilers get replaced by? Broncos, right?
I have no idea. Dude, why does it keep doing that?
I can't. I have an Oilers card, though.
Dude, go Cubs.
Oh, goddamn, another bandwagon.
Hey, look on my Facebook. I liked them ever since, like, 4 years ago when they were shit.
That's true, yeah. I went to a Cubs game when they were shit and they won, actually, so.
See, that was the prediction right there. Them winning that game. They didn't even get a good win this year.
Do we even have any?
They clinched their division, though. They clinched their
division. We're just rambling.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah, we're all right.
We're
football. Keep on football.
Oh, by the way, Jake, next podcast, are we doing?
Big guy.
Questions.
Big guy.
Questions.
Let's talk about big guy. Let's talk about big guy. Who's big guy?
So. I'm the only one who's paying attention. Like, who actually? Am I the only one who actually watched a football game last week? Like,
skinny penis.
Chez, you watched? You watched one last week?
I wonder if skinny penis is gonna go online.
Who'd you watch?
I watched.
Wait, check if he's online actually.
Look if skinny penis is online.
Actually, no.
Look for big guy.
He turned his profile offline last night.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Look up for big guy.
All right, Chez.
I watched the
last time
Lions versus
the
Colts.
Alright, so we watched the Lions game. I watched the...
Skinny penis!
No. Bryce.
I watched two games.
No.
No, not two games.
Bryce,
yeah, two games.
Bryce when he sees men. Bryce when he sees a girl.
I'm glad we're on an audio podcast and you guys are doing that. That's great.
Yeah, Bryce... Yeah. Bryce is about an inch.
They're talking about small pee-pee. That's what they're talking about.
Skinny penis!
Yeah, that's not even bring up.
I doubt he's even going to watch the end of it, so.
Yeah, I
probably
did.
Won't.
That's perfectly
fine. We did it.
Guys, we can ramble for six more kills, can't we?
Yeah, we're going to ramble for about six more kills.
Six more kills, and we're going to watch Logan open his gold case, and then...
And then we're gonna go to Bucks, and then talk about skinny penis.
I need to go grab money or something like that. If we're gonna go there,
I have some change, but we can sell it.
I have no
here.
Money. Because I spent it on Subway yesterday with
you
guys.
Oh, tell me the Subway story.
Oh, okay, so basically, Jake's got these coupons, right? And it's you buy. Coupons? So you buy a 21 ounce drink and one 6 inch, and you get a free 6 inch
That's
with
game.
That. But
I better got
what they did, and I don't know if the guy was new or something.
No, he's not new.
But, okay, so all we did, we only paid for the drink,
yeah.
Which was $1.70, right?
And then we said...
So we got an entire foot long for free, basically.
Yeah, we got a foot long for free, and we just paid for the drink.
Why not?
And then I was like, well, I got all this money left over. Logan, go buy a sub. So we gave him another coupon, but he had to pay full price because, I don't know.
And then they had to pay full price that time for the 6-inch and the...
Well, no, he got a foot long.
Yeah, but you...
Yeah, so he only had to pay for 1 6-inch.
Yeah.
Right.
So basically, we bought 2 footlongs and a drink for like...
$7.
$7.
All right, so... I got two things that I can...
We have to show this about. Hurry up, because the podcast is ending.
Shut up. Shut the fuck up.
No, he's got to open his gold case.
Okay. So it's 24...
Bengals are going to win.
Guys... In the fourth quarter with 1 minute left,
24-16 Steelers are beating the Bengals.
Who has the ball?
I think, dude, it doesn't matter. They can't win.
Yeah, they can. A minute left.
Jake, don't mean to save these.
What if they were on the red zone, Davin? I'm pretty sure they could have won.
Yeah, there you go.
That's
Bobby.
True, but.
Ooh, look at that supply drop.
Can I just open all these?
Yeah, just
yeah.
I think my next game, by the way, that I'm going to be playing.
Yeah, we could put this in the title. Battlefield before gold packs.
Yeah, that's what I should do. Put Battlefield gold packs and then, like, space it out and put, like, podcast.
Crap.
All right, let's see what you get. Okay, we didn't even get a 200 boost.
Yeah.
All right, guys, that was the podcast. Woo!
How long was it?
Look at my KD. I'm a savage.
Hey, how long
yeah,
was it?
Yeah, shit.
All right, it's been about an hour.
An hour?
Yeah, fuck you. We're going to end on an hour and a minute.
All right, sir.
So basically, I hope you have enjoyed. This was...
CHEDZY.
Yeah.
Frigid Gaming.
And Haven Edge. Yep, everyone's gonna make fun of me at school again, cause
why?
Cause they did last time. They're like, it's Haven Edge. I'm just like, fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck
it. Nah, I was just
you.
Kidding. I'm just kidding.
Fuck off.
I'm a savage.
Fuck
I don't give
you,
a
bud.
Shit.
Fuck off.
There guys, you. Give me subs. I lost 2 subs in the subs purge.
That's right.
The subs purge.
Yeah. All right. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed and goodbye, basically.